Hello everyone, welcome to the first episode of Cheap Tricks, a brand new magic video series right here on channel5.com, bringing you budget magic builds. Every week, I'm going to get it done with a deck on the ladder that maybe clocks in a little under what some of the huge, big, mythic decks are costing these days. And hopefully we pick up a couple of wins along the way. But if not, we're certainly going to have some fun. This time we are kicking things off with a deck built around, built around quite a few cards, actually. The main conceit of this deck, right, is casting Solar Blaze and Deafening Clarion to manage the board, while also playing a bunch of creatures ourselves, none of which die to either of these cards. So, of course, the centerpiece of the deck is Stormwild Caprador. Stormwild Caprador plus any damage spell, any of these, it just puts counters on it. So if you cast a Stormwild Caprador and then a Deafening Clarion, it gets +3/+3 permanently. It gets those counters on it. As indeed is the case with Scorching Dragonfire. Justice Strike, unfortunately, puts one counter until you start building it up. But Stormwild Caprador is the perfect card to have in a deck that is looking to play damage-based removal, especially damage-based sweepers like this, because it synergizes so well. As indeed do some other cards. Lava Brink Venturer. If you name Odd with Lava Brink Venturer, not only does Deafening Clarion do no damage to it, nor does, I was surprised to learn, Solar Blaze, because the Venturer should deal damage to itself, but it actually has protection from itself because it's an Odd converted mana cost. So that's a wild interaction I had no idea about until I saw that. Absolutely wild indeed. Tectonic Giant, same situation. Cavalier of Dawn, neither of these die to either Deafening Clarion or Solar Blaze. And of course, we are playing the new absolute all-star from M21. I love this card, Brash Taunter. Being indestructible, it doesn't die to these damage-based spells. And of course, you know, it's got the old Boros Reckoner effect. You can deal damage to them. The old stuffy doll, deal damage to them whenever it's dealt damage. So, you know, this deck is it's full of internal synergy. And we don't have to take too many hits on the on the budget, to be honest. Obviously, we're playing Windscarred Crag instead of Sacred Foundry. And it would be nice to play 6-mana Chandra as well, Chandra Awakened Inferno. But overall, not making too many compromises for the back pocket here, it's not too bad. And this deck, look, win, lose, or draw, it is a ton of fun to play, and it really catches people by surprise. So let's get to it. Of course, a reminder that you can buy these cards at channelfireball.com. This deck clocks in at just under $40, including the sideboard, which is a pretty good deal considering that you're going to have all sorts of fun with this. And, you know, if you've got the Chandra, if you've got the Sacred Foundries lying around, then you can upgrade the deck as you see fit. But of course, at channelfireball.com, you should be able to click a link below this video or on the page on channelfireball.com and actually instantly see this deck laid out in your in the deck list builder there. And $40 for a list like this, it's not too bad. Anyway, let's get to the games and see how storm wild we can get with these Capradors here. Let's get underway here. Currently stuck in Platinum Hell. It's early on in the month, and the ranks have just reset, so I'm on that grind up to Mythic. Hopefully we can maybe make a dent in that today. All right, this seems like a decent hand. Old Windscarred Crag here. it's pretty loose, but I think that's the price you pay. Well, it's the price you don't pay, isn't it? It's the price you don't pay. Now, we could play the Temple here, but I like playing the Windscarred Crag, because I'm not exactly sure what I want. I suppose I could Temple, try to get a Scorching Dragonfire or something like that. It's probably going to be good against, this is cycling. So something to snag an early Fox is going to be okay. But Fox dies to the Justice Strike. Elspeth Conqueror's Death is going to be very, very bad. It's going to be a huge liability here. But it's not going to be the end of the world. Solar Blaze is also going to help us clean up a little bit too, so that's a nice draw. So, I think I just want to cast. I want to cast the Caprador and Lava Brink Venturer. No, I don't think we want that. I just think we want some lands here. Make sure we can get out our Brash Taunter and that sort of thing. But I like casting the Caprador here. Get that online before we start. Okay, this Solar Blaze is going to be real nice here. This Solar Blaze is going to be really nice. And that's the good thing about, you know, a lot of threats in Standard have square stats, so they die to Solar Blaze. There aren't too many creatures that. That don't. Okay, Birth of Miletus. A little bit late there. A little bit late on the old birth, but that's okay. So Stormwind Caprador will probably cast Solar Blaze next turn and just take out 2-for-1. But let's see what they do. Otherwise, we could maybe go Justice Strike Birth. We'll see. Let's see. Like, I wouldn't be surprised if they just don't play anything else. There's a little bit of incidental life gain in this deck as well, between Deafening Clarion, a couple of other cards. You know, Bertha Miletus. So hopefully we can stay out of range of old mate. Are they just putting the Lurus in the hand there? Now, how greedy do we get, I wonder? How greedy do we get? I feel like we get a little bit greedy. Maybe get one more creature out of them. They're only doing two to us a turn. Yeah. Let's get a little bit greedy. I'll play the Bertha Miletus. I'll get a Plains. We can keep up the Justice Strike, although I don't anticipate casting it. I don't think we're going to cast it. Really important to remember, and this is something that I've mucked up on my stream a lot. Really important to remember that Justice Strike is basically +1/+1 for Stormwild Caprador, whereas Scorching Dragonfire is +3/+3. So often what will happen is, for example, in this situation here, I'll be like, oh, before they attack, I better, you know, cast the Justice Strike on their Drownstinger to kill it, whereas I could actually just cast the Dragonfire. I could cast the Dragonfire on my Caprador and then block it instead. I mean, it also works with the Justice Strike here. So let's see what they do. We don't really need to waste the Justice Strike. Like, there's not really any point because we're just untapping and casting the Solar Blaze. Yeah, I'm just, like, I guess the only problem is, oh, they've only got 5 cyclers in the bin. It's not a huge amount. We'll just take another 2. Just take another 2 here. It's good of them to tap out as well beforehand. Not that they can do much to debuff their creatures. Yep, so we'll just go Solar Blaze, blow up their board. They do gain 3 life because the Lurus does actually deal damage to itself. And a Scorching Dragonfire. I don't think we need that, although it does buff up the Stormwild Caprador. This is a... No, I think we just don't need it. I think we can just do better. All right, and then we can attack. Bang. I think we just want, like, a Sweeper. We want a Deafening Clarion, or... We've got an answer to a Fox, if they play out a Fox. They may just be on Mono Sweepers now. All right, Brash Taunter next turn. I'm going to do that anyway. Okay. Game 2. Brash Taunter. I don't know if you've played much of this card. It is so much fun. It is so much fun, this card. I've drafted a bunch in Limited. it's just unbeatable. It's so good. And it can fight your own creatures as well to deal extra damage. All right, a Zenith Flare. That's not good news for us. That is, in fact, very bad news for us. And now we're just playing the Do They Have the Second Zenith Flare. Interesting to play the Cycler after the Zenith Flare there. And they've probably got a second Zenith Flare. Okay. All right. Well, fair dues. Can't really beat that. That's just the way that goes there. If they were going to contest, if they had a creature heavy draw, we were going to do pretty well there. But double Zenith Flare, they're going to get you every time. All right. We continue, my friends. And face off against our next foe. See if we can pick up a W here. This hand is a little risky. It has plenty of white mana. If we draw a red source, we're in business, though, I think. As soon as we draw a red source, I think we're fine. Let's put our opponents up to Watery Grave. Ah, perfect. There we go. Ascend the Mountain. Got the Caprador next turn. Scorching Dragonfire is +3/+3 permanently. Brash Tauntarino for later on. ECD. Ah, we got some good options here. All right. And old Stonecoil Serpent. It's fine. Make a 0/4, make a 1/3. I like how the Stormwild Caprador makes both a bird and a goat sound, as indeed it should. Crystal Giant, sure. Gets trample, right. So can't attack, that's fine. And then we go... Yeah, so now this is fine, right? We've got no attacks. Hopefully they make some attacks next turn. I mean, there's not really any point to them doing it because we've got... Wait, they've got Animal Sanctuary? Okay, weird. Now, I guess if it gets hexproof, that's really bad for us. That's fine. So, lifelink on that one, and lifelink on that one too, alright. Alright, well, let's make the Caprador huge. Oh, yeah. 4/6 fire. Okay, not what we wanted, but I guess I'll take it. The planes off the top, no, also no good. And let's get in with the old Caprador. Now this has reach, but that's okay. We're attacking with a 4/6. And I'll probably blast one of the Crystalline Giants. Yeah, I'll probably blast one of the Crystalline Giants here. We can't blast the Justice Strike. Ooh, dear. Okay, yeah. Well, that's... Maybe we have to blast that, actually. Yeah, we actually probably have to blast that. That's such a huge threat. Yeah, this is fine. So we'll just kill the Steel Overseer. Okay, is that first strike? Yeah, first strike and menace. All right, so we can't block that one. So block this one. Take five. Maybe we just sit back on the Caprador here. I don't know. We've definitely got to kill the Steel Overseer. Right. Our post combat haste creature is pretty strong. Yeah, this is an interesting deck. I've never seen a deck like this before. So, let's EC. Are we bringing anything back? No. All right. Well, let's just ECD this one because we can't block it. And I guess I just won't attack. I just won't attack with the Caprador. They're gaining a lot of life with their 3/3. We'll just play some Brash Taunters and right, another Steel Overseer. Right, that's the problem. So now is where imagine a Solar Blaze here. Imagine a Solar Blaze. Okay, so they make the Gingerbread unblockable. Sure. Bang. Oh! Mwah. Oh, you love to see it. Oh, you love to see it. Look at this. Outstanding move. And we attack for 8. Oh my goodness. Oh! So good. So good. Oh my goodness me. And the thing is, like, usually Solar Blaze is pretty bad with the Caprador, right? Because it only puts one extra counter on. Because we'd already had 4, we got 4 extra... Oh, mate. A masterpiece. Beautiful. All right, starting to get a sense of what the deck is capable of here, which is pretty good. All right, up against Dan Awesome here. Okay. Let's see if Dan Awesome can live up to their name. Well, I hope Dan Awesome is playing a creature-based aggressive deck, because if so, I don't think we can lose. All right. Okay. Not good. Not good. No. Probably just Sultai nonsense here. So the Deafening Clarions and the Solar Blazers may not have as much utility as we perhaps hoped. Yeah. Just Simic-based nonsense once again. But it's all right. It's okay. Another Arboreal Grazer. Well, I mean, the Deafening Clarion is not really the 2-for-1 that, you know, you're hoping to get. You're not... Oh, and the attack from Dan Awesome as well. But, I mean, this is fine, right? This is totally fine. It's turn 2, and our opponent has 7 permanents on the battlefield, 5 Witcher lands. Totally fine. Not a problem. Not an issue at all. I mean, whoever looks at that and goes, that's problematic. Absolutely not. Not a worry. Not a worry. Okay, Paravise Druid. So now the biggest enemy, Dan Awesome getting in once again. The biggest enemy we have is really just the top of Dan Awesome's deck. Let's just get rid of all these creatures here. Because it's now if they draw the Nissa, the Vraska, the Ugin. Ugin's not an issue yet. But soon. What is this? Oh my goodness. A turn 4 casualties of war, you say. Very well. Yeah. So now it's just what Dan top decks. That was pretty disgusting. Alright. Zagoth Triumph, sure. And a Paradise Druid. Okay. Well, Tectonic Giant's not too bad. Maybe I should have killed the Paradise Druid in case they draw Ugin. Like, they can't cast Ugin this turn though. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, no. That's 7 mana. All right. Yeah. I don't know. We've got another removal spell here. Another Casualties of War, perhaps? No, just a land. Okay. So here, I think we do just get rid of the... Yeah, I'm happy to do that. So, do this and this. And this is the whole deck is built around the fact that our creatures, don't die. I should be going full aggro, shouldn't I? Yeah, I should be going full aggro. I should be dealing 3. I should be attacking for 6, basically, with this guy. Get rid of that. Yeah. We don't need extra cards. We just need to get them dead before they draw, like, the Ugin or the... Okay, Scavenging Ooze is fine. We can kill that. 6 mana. Oh, right. Yeah, with the Castle Garenbrig. and just exile my entire library. I don't have any creatures. They do. All right, but again, Solar Blaze. Solar Blaze takes care of this very neatly. Yep. So the Justice Strike that I put below would have been pretty good here. Okay, yep, chomp up your graveyard. No worries, Dan. No worries, old mate. Another Paradise Druid, yep, 6-6. Is either that or we can double Scorching Dragonfire. Okay, munching up our cards in our graveyard. Doesn't really do much. I mean, we've got ECD in this deck, but munching up the Deafening Clarence doesn't do a whole lot. So, this is fine. So we just go Solar Blaze, kill the Skooz, attack, and yeah, let's try to get him dead here. Down to 13, we gain a life. I don't know. Now I'm beginning to think I should be drawing extra cards. Okay. Here's a Casualties of War. I guess take another three, right? Yeah. And this is fine because we can go, yeah, play the Cav. Can't destroy anything. Oh, we could destroy itself, I guess, in fairness, but that's not happening, obviously. So really, yeah, we're just playing against the top of Dan Awesome's deck. Zagoth Triumph. And Ugin is bad news. Zagoth Triumph, right. Okay, Birth of Miletus. Go and get a Plains. Play the Plains. We've got an answer to an Uro. If they play an Uro, we can Scorching Dragonfire it with a trigger on the stack. We've got an answer to an Ugin, actually, in Scorching Dragonfire as well. Is this another Casualties of War? Oh my goodness. Wow. I mean, that's why you play the deck, right? So you draw your good... That's why you play them. So we can bring back a Birth of Miletus here. Guess it gets an extra planes out of our deck. So we'll go Birth. Get a Plains. We just need to close. We just need to finish. It's just a race against time. And let's play a Scryland rather than the Plains. No, we don't need that. We've got plenty of them. Okay. Now Ugin is the problem, though. Okay, good, good, good. Ooh, Stormlight Caprador. That's lethal next turn. So let's hope. We've got to fade one draw step here. We've got to fade one draw step against Dan Awesome. Eight to Extinction. Oh, my goodness. Oh my goodness. If it were anything else, like if it were any, oh no, not anything else, but like if it, oh no, it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. If only these were bloody lightning strikes, we'd also have this game. All right, Tectonic Giant. Tectonic Giant, here we go. Again, dead next turn. Dead next turn, Dan Awesome. Again off the top. Anything, something good? Oh my goodness. The top decks are so real. It's unbelievable. Okay. Yep. So I'll sacrifice these two, I guess. Okay, and a Windscarred Crag is not what we wanted to see. Okay, come on. Yeah, alright. Now it's gonna start becoming a problem. Yeah. Now it's gonna start becoming a problem, I would have thought. Alright, Lava Brink Venturer. So we actually give this protection from even here. I guess they'll just make a sacrifice, but we make it even because zero is even, according to mathematologist Franciscus Karsten. So this means they can't block it with any tokens. So they kind of have to kill it, right? Maybe not. Yeah, they're going to. That makes sense. So let me see here. It's on three. Let's just blast it. I will rise. But that's the problem is now Dan's pulled ahead on cards. Oh dear. Oh dear. This isn't good. What is this? Uro? Another Scavenging Ooze? Well, I feel like we ground really, really well here. But a couple of tidy top decks from... okay, well, this one. I think this one is getting out of our reach here. Yeah, no, I don't think we're going to win this one anymore, my friends. I don't think we're going to win this one. Few too many of the old lands. Few too many of the old answers from Dan Awesome there. And Anissa as well. Yeah, alright, okay. I think we'll pack it up at this point. Wake us up. Attack us for 11. Yeah. All right. I'm going to do that thing, you know, when you're playing against someone and they like draw the card and then concede in case there's some magical card that's going to get me out of this. There's really not, though. Stormwild Caprador, perfect. Yeah, no. All right. Well, we fought bravely, but unable to get across the line there. Very unfortunate. All right, let's see who's next up. Mijay, not UJ, is the name of our opponent. I don't know if that's some kind of cryptic code. All right, keep this hand. Seems pretty good. All right. Oh, excuse me. Inquisitive Puppet. Is this another, like, weird Steel Overseer brew? Let's find out. I think the Stormwild Caprador plus Deafening Clarion is going to be pretty good here, I would imagine. Ooh, another Stormwild Caprador. Yeah, sure, let's get wild up in here. Let's get wild. If they're just going to play out small creatures, like, what is this? Okay, alright, artifact-based nonsense. Yeah, good. Well, this Deafening Clarion's going to clean up. So, I'm probably going to be very greedy and cast both Stormwild Caprators before the Deafening Clarion. Casting Deafening Clarion with Stormwild Caprador is bananas. It's so good. You make a 4-6, you give it lifelink, you Plague Wind your opponent if they're playing some small aggressive deck like this, and get in for 4 lifelink. Yeah, okay, all right. So, I really want to be greedy and play the second Stormwild Caprador. Oh, I want to be so greedy and play the second Stormwild Caprador. So, let's see. They can't activate it. It's fine. We can do it, right? We can get away with it. We play the second Stormwild. Yeah, we can do it. It's fine. It'll be fine. What can go wrong? It'll be okay. So they can untap. They can play the Steel Over. They can activate the Steel Overseer. I guess maybe they'll keep this. Do they keep the Inquisitive Puppet? No, because I only get one activation of the Steel Overseer before I cast a Deafening Clarion. Oh no, but they can activate it again with Manifold Key. So they can keep the Inquisitive... Okay, oh yeah. Alright. So they do keep the Inquisitive Puppet. But that's okay. That's alright. I can live with that. Alright, I will block... Are they playing like Giant Growth? Stony Strength! Oh no! Oh no! I mean, it's not a disaster because we've got Solar Blaze, but that is... You really hate to see that. Should have just not blocked, I guess. I mean, at least this gets them. So now we just have to deal with the Inquisitive Puppet. Good game, says our opponent. I mean, it's not over yet, surely. Another Inquisitive Puppet. Sure. And an Evolution Sage. Oh, to proliferate, that's kind of cool. All right, so we're going to get some value off of this. Yeah, this will be fine. So let's go. It's not quite the Deafening Clarion that I hoped for, but it's probably the Deafening Clarion that I deserve. So we go Deafening Clarion. Attack for 5 lifelink. Yeah, exiling between the Inquisitive Puppet doesn't really do anything there. Do we just get rid of that one as well? Just for the rub-ins? We can also Scorching Dragonfire our Stormwild Caprador to make it even bigger. Sure. Attack for 8 lifelink. Oh, mate. Most of the time with these bloody Scorching Dragonfires, I just want to cast them at our own creature here. Beautiful. Oh, fantastic. You love to see it. So, Inquisitive Puppet plus Manifold Key versus a Goat Bird. Who would win? Let's find out. All right, no attacks. Interesting. Let's attack. Is there anything they can do? Oh, they can... Oh, target creature can't be blocked. So now they can't block it. A smart play. Make a little human there. And bang, get in there. All right, GG. Ah, the power. The power of the Stormwild Caprador. My goodness. All right, let's get back into it here. Get another one going. Against Mahui. Pretty unexciting hand, but I guess we can keep it. Doesn't really do a whole lot, but yeah, whatever. It's better than going to 7, I think. Okay, alright. We do need to make sure we don't just brick off here, but this... Birth of Miletus and Scorching Dragonfire are a good start. Obviously, if we draw, like, Deafening Clarion or something, it's going to be good. Solar Blaze can hopefully do some work, but again, if they go Torbran... Yeah, Torbran's no good. Okay. Double Fervo is a very good start for them. We probably have to just Scorching Dragonfire next turn, to be honest. And a Rimrock Knight as well. Ooh, she can take a lot of damage. 7 damage by turn 2. Gross. Ooh, Deafening Clarion's very good. Okay, so let's play this. Tempt Fate. Yeah, get a little greedy here. Hopefully they play out two more one drops. Maybe they just play the Rimrock Knight. I don't really care as long as it's another creature, so we can get them with Deafening Clarion here. Yes, we're going to play the Rimrock Knight by the look of things. And, oh, a light up the stage. Double Torps, good. So they can't cast either. Oh, no. Oh, they just cast nothing. Stone nothing. Okay. So now do we even cast the Deafening Clarion? What have they got in hand? They got a shock in hand. They've got a shock or another Rimrock Knight in hand because it paused there. So we can either cast the Deafening Clarion or we can cast Scorching Dragonfire. I like the score. I'm gonna cast the Scorching Dragonfire. Hopefully get that Boulder Rush out of their hand by blocking. Yeah, this is fine. Sure. Yep, resolve. No worries. And then block. And Scorching Dragonfire this one. And I wonder if they'll Boulder Rush the other one. Or if they just cast this Rimrock Knight from Exile. That light up the stage is pretty brutal for the opponent. They're clearly missing... Oh, no, they're trying to cast and a shock. Yeah, okay. So they have a shock, not another Rimrock Knight in hand. Okay. So I gain another point of life. I'll just cast another Scorching Dragonfire here. Once we get this Brash Taunter online, it's going to be pretty good. I guess I can just take one. Yeah, I'll just take one. It's fine. So now they're almost certainly going to cast that Rimrock Knight. And then we can clean them up with the Deafening Clarion. Yeah, this is fine. This is fine. Okay. Brash Taunter is also pretty good against both them. Ooh, interesting. Embercleave next turn. Yeah, so that's they're going to go to waste too. That's good. All right. So, let's go. Ooh, Windscarred Crag's nice. We gain a little bit of life. And Deafening Clarion, kill both of them. Although, Brash Taunter would have... No, because if they get an... They can just play the Embercleave if we leave the creatures. So we have to get rid of the creatures. Annex. So Annex, and they've wasted it. They don't have... They're already missing an Embercleave. So Brash Taunter. Kind of makes it tough for them to attack. Also, we can just Scorching Dragonfire the Annex. I don't think there's not an answer for the Brash Taunter in their deck. The best card against it is Embercleave. Bone Crusher Giant. Okay, yeah, so... Oh, mate! Oh! Wow. Wow. I don't know if our opponent was, like, trying to assert their dominance there, but that was really something. So here we go. Stormwild Caprador. Solar Blaze. Kill both of them. They get two Satyrs. They take one. They get three. Whoops. Okay. Oh, I guess that's kind of bad. Maybe I should have just killed the Annex. An Embercleave here is terrible for us. Nope. Okay. Wow. I've never seen someone be so unafraid of Stormwild Capra, of Brash Taunter. Okay, and an Annex there. Well, we'll definitely Scorching Dragonfire the Annex. The question is, what else do we do? I guess just play this fellow. This is just such a bad matchup for them, really. Are these in exile off of the... They're in exile off of the light up the stage. They can cast them next turn. Yeah. We're going to try to coax the Rimrock Knight thing out of them. We can kill this Satyr. We're actually pretty good even against Embercleave here, because we can kill both of their creatures. Yep, sure. So block this and block that. I guess we just let this damage happen, right? Yeah. Take another one from the... Yeah, they've had enough. I was wondering like whether to fire off that, but if they Embercleave, it's pretty bad. I think overall it was a horrendous position for the mono red player. This deck does have a pretty good matchup against mono red, assuming they don't get a tour right now. It's pretty good. Okay, here we go once again. What's our opponent up to this time? Ugh. I don't like this hand very much. Like, it's okay, but it's not sort of what this deck does best. Ooh, an island, a basic island. In this economy, a basic island. We haven't been too badly punished by the Windscarred Crag so far. Spectral Sailor, yeah. Right. Give me some mono blue flash nonsense here, I would guess. I wonder if they're going to counter the Birth of Miletus. No. Okay. They'll probably just counter our Solar Blaze. I can't imagine this is a good matchup for us, though. Like, we've just got big, dumb sorcery speed cards, and they've got, you know, counter spells, flash threats, that sort of stuff. Like, on this board, the Solar Blaze seems great, but... Ooh. Maybe missing lands? Bottoming one? Yeah. Maybe I'll... Nope, they've got a land, don't worry about it. Okay. So, Dragonfire. Scorching Dragonfire. I'll just play the Lava Brink Venturer. Name odd. Are they going to counter this? I mean, I'm happier if they counter this, so we got the Solar Blaze next turn. I wonder what they're up to. Third Quench, yeah, okay. All right. Well, that makes it slightly likelier than that our Solar Blaze resolves next turn, but not hugely likelier. Okay. I will block. Take one. I mean, I wonder if we even go for it. I won't even cast it. Let's see what they do. End turn. Because we've got Scorching Dragonfire and Justice Strike at instant speed. Sure. It's pretty good. One mana Omen of the Sea, thanks to the Cunning Knight Bonder. Okay, and they topped two? Gross. Gross, gross, gross. Ooh, Brazen Borrower bouncing that. Well, I guess we just now destroy their board. Like, it removes this removes the zero field, but I don't really care about that. Yeah, they just never tap out again. But I guess we just make tokens now. Like, if they flash in their Brazen Borrower, that's fine. I mean, that beats us in the long run, but what can we do? A Spectral Sailor as well. Man, if we ever get to resolve this Solar Blaze, it's going to be good. They're just never going to tap out is the thing. We just got to hope that they... hope they don't have a counterspell. We've got two cards in hand. I mean, I'm gonna have to fire off the Solar Blaze next turn, I think. Well, maybe not. Yeah, maybe not. Maybe they'll use a counter spell against on my Brash Taunter here. Brash Taunter's pretty good, actually, if it resolves. Yeah, I just realized how good it is because it can just slowly pick off, like it can pick off the Brazen Borrower, pick off the Spectral Sailor. Well, hopefully with the one card in hand, they don't have a counter spell here. Although, you know, hopefully, huh? Solar Blaze one time. I guess I'll attack first. Yep. Take one, and Solar Blaze. One time. Good sign. Yes, 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 yes. I guess we can Scorching Dragonfly something as well, which isn't too bad. Alright, alright, alright. Well, if they're just on the mono nothings now, what are we going to get from this Temple of Triumph? Don't want another one of them, that's fine. And now we can... I guess we won't destroy anything. Yeah, well, like we could destroy their Omen of the Sea, but just giving them a 3-3 is... Like, I'd rather have the Scry too. I wonder if they're just sitting on Quench, that'd be so sick. The Cavalier isn't super impressive in this deck. Maybe the... It's just better as better. It's more, there's more copies of Elspeth Conquers Death. That's not impossible. It's not impossible that it's better to just play more ECDs. ECD is also a little bit cheaper than Cav as well. I think it's like Cav's like $3 and the ECD is like $2.20. Knock an extra couple of cents off there. Okay. This, I'm just going to kill now. Mono blue flash, huh? I wonder how they deal with the big 4/6. Ooh, ECD. Okay. I guess they've got like Shark Typhoon. Okay, it's a good start. We haven't really had Castle Ardenvale do anything, but now it's gonna start to do. Now it's gonna start to do stuff here. So that's good. Right, Cunning Night Bonder, can't attack. Thanks to the vigilance on the Cav. Castle Ardenvale does add a couple of extra bucks to this deck, but I think it's worth it. I think we're seeing why here. You know, we've had a couple of games where it's been drawn out, or a Castle Ardenvale can make the difference. I don't know. Castle Embereth, I don't think is very good in this deck. It doesn't go very wide. Like giving your 8/10 Stormwild Caprador +1/+0 is not that great, right? An opt, sure. What do we get back with an ECD? The Taunter, it's pretty good. Another opt. I'm just wondering whether we even just cast this like naked. Probably not. Okay, and bottoming a card with an opt's a good sign. Okay. They still can't attack. I mean, nor can we with our Castle Ardenvale tokens, right? Let's get eaten up. Well, the good news is if we draw a land, we can activate Castle Ardenvale again. So here I'm going to attack with both, because this actually shortens the clock by one turn. So this puts them to 5, which means that we kill them next turn if I make another Castle Ardenvale token. And I will go even with this. Controversial choice, but I'm going to go even. Neutralize. I'm not going to go anything with it, I've decided, actually. But, yeah, the attack with the token might have seemed weird, but it actually, because we can make another Castle Ardenvale token and then attack, it actually took an entire turn off the clock, even though it cost us one token. So, very much worth it. Well and truly worth it there. All right, excellent. Okay, one more here, I think. We'll wrap things up. Ooh, playing against Pliny. I wonder if it's Pliny the Elder or Pliny the Younger. Famed historian. Personal hero of mine. All right, let's get some Pliny facts going. Selfless Savior. Are we playing against Paw Blade here, as it's known? I think we just want lands here. Pliny the Elder, Roman author, naturalist, natural philosopher, naval and army commander of the early Roman Empire, and a friend of Emperor Vespasian. Yes, this is Paw Blade here. And so there's Pliny the Elder, and then there was also Pliny the Younger, who was his nephew. Was a lawyer, author, magistrate of ancient Rome, raised by Pliny the Elder. Weird to be named after your uncle. Weird to be named after your uncle. But both of them are very interesting blokes. Haven't read about them for a while, actually. Forgotten what their whole deal is. And if you're interested in more history facts, why not visit halfasshistory.net and listen to me talk about history every week. Okay. We just need a... we just need a Deafening Clarion. Deafening Clarion's going to be very strong. So I'll just play the old Caprador here. This Houndmaster gets large and in charge. It's a bit of a problem. I suppose Scorching Dragonfire is a nice, neat answer to it. The real problem is Embercleave. Embercleave's going to do a number on us here. That Selfless Savior as well can mess things up for us a little bit. Oh, we can't block at all, can we? Can they activate this? They can activate this twice. Oh, let's make them do it. This wall's not doing a whole lot else. No, they're not. Okay, good. They've got something else. I guess they just want to cast out a... Oh, Hack Toss. Four? No, that's good. Solar Blaze. Oh! All right, well, I mean, we'll still cast the Deafening Clarion. But Solar Blaze would kill this Hack Toss. I mean, it's still a really good Clarion, right? Still a really good Clarion. They can... Oh, no, wait. They can... It's not at that great a Clarion. We can keep... They can keep something around with the Selfless Savior. Or not. Sure. Cool. Bang. So now, can we race this Hack Toss or can we find an answer to it? I guess we can block it with the Tectonic Giant as well. That's not too bad. I don't know. Maybe I should have got greedy there and play and wait for them to play the Watchdog and the Cur. I'm just going to play Tectonic Giant next turn. So we take six. Sure. Take six. Oh, we can't play the Tectonic Giant because I don't have... Oh, man. This is there. And there's the punishment. That's the first time we've been punished there. I guess I'll just wait then. No attacks. End turn. We've got the Scorching Dragon. Fire. We take another six from the Hack Toss. Do they attack? They're not going to attack with the other dogs, are they? Oh, they do. Okay. Well, in that case, we'll block. They're going to pump it. Sure. Pump it once. Pump it twice. Sure. And then pump it three times. And now, we don't Scorching Dragonfire the dog. We Scorching Dragonfire the Caprador, right? So it becomes a 7-9 and still kills the Cur. So it's the same result, except obviously they end up with it in the graveyard rather than the exile zone, but we end up with a 7-9, which is pretty strong. So we play this Tectonic Giant so we can block Hack Toss. We attack for this in the air, and we got him dead next turn. Oh, actually, no, we don't. No, we don't. I was going to say we got him dead next turn because of the Tectonic Giant. Oh, what do we do? Actually, if they've got an Embercleave, we're just dead. But no, great, excellent, wow. Okay, so if they attacked with a Hack Toss, we had a couple of options. We could have actually taken it and gone to three, right? And then attack back with the Tectonic Giant, done three damage to them and seven upstairs. Yeah, they really need an Embercleave. This deck's pretty bad against Embercleave, but apart from that, wow, I think we've done pretty well. I think we've done pretty well here. Well, this deck gave a very good account of itself, I would have thought. It showed exactly what it's capable of. It showed some of the stuff it's good at, showed some of the stuff that it's maybe not so good at. If you want to make some adjustments, if your budget allows. Now, again, this deck is available for about $40 on channelfiper.com. You can go and buy all those cards there for about $40. Some of them may be a little low in stock, so you might want to get in quick. But if you want to make some improvements, obviously the Windscarred Crags come out for the Sacred Foundries. I wouldn't, maybe you don't want to buy Sacred Foundries now, considering they're rotating out pretty soon. Even I would say Raugrim Triome is better than Windscarred Crag, but again, it's a little pricier. And probably if you want to find some room for Elspeth, the Cavaliers aren't super great. Not Elspeth, sorry. Chandra. If you want to maybe cut those Cavaliers, play two copies of Chandra. But apart from that, I mean, Justice Strike hasn't been fantastic. The Lava Ring Venture is kind of cool rather than being very powerful. It can be a huge roadblock on defense. We didn't really see it happen there. But, the fact that... I think the most fun you have with Lava Ring Venture is casting Lava Ring Venture and Deafening Clarion say, oh, no, it doesn't die. And then casting Solar Blaze and still saying, no, it doesn't die. It's got protection from both Clarion and the Solar Blaze, which is pretty cool. But no, look, this deck is very fun. It's right. It's really out there. It's going to take your opponents by surprise. And, got a nice little upgrade with M21 and Brash Taunter. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you enjoyed playing this deck. Again, jump over to channelfireball.com if you want to get your hands on it. $40 and it's yours, which is pretty good, I would say. It's you're going to get some good bang for your buck there. Anyway, That is Cheap Tricks for this week. Hope you'll join me again next week. Please send through any feedback on Twitter if you've got any ideas for how this video series could be made better. If you've got any brews you want to check out as well, on Twitter at Riley Brew Tower, or you can join my Discord, bit.ly/joinRiley's Discord, and you'll be able to come and hang out with some other cool people. And me, also. I'll be there too, if you want to come and make any deck suggestions or anything else like that. But apart from that, thanks for tuning in. I hope you've enjoyed this. Take care of yourselves, and I'll see you next time.